Have you watched this TV show, Two Broke Girls? Max and Caroline are a study in contrast. I pay special attention to Max because she is an accurate version of how most of us are. Always trash talking about self, putting herself down and putting a negative spin on pretty much everything about and around her. We are all familiar with it because we all hear it from time to time. Or perhaps you hear it all the time. Voices like, I'm just a fat cow with no willpower. Or, what a dummy you are. You cannot do anything right. Or, you messed up a perfectly good opportunity. You good for nothing. And that is the focus of this video. How to silence our inner mean voice. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on. If you could only listen to your mind, you will notice that it is a noisy little marketplace. So many thoughts, so many opinions, so many judgments, and always this nagging voice inside of you that's always poking at your uncertainties and weak spots. For some of us, it sounds like the bully from fourth grade. For others, it's the voice of some mean ex-boss, one of their parents, or some other figure that has an overwhelming emotional impact. Whatever its nature or tone, this inner critic appears to have the same goal across the board. It seems hell-bent on knocking you down and making you doubt yourself. Now, psychologists say that a little self-criticism may be okay because it gives us that reality check to become better. But on the other hand, excessive self-criticism, studies show, leads to chronic anxiety and stress and depression. Not very good side effects. When it gets the best of us, we can really get bogged down and all our positive intentions quickly go out of the window. So, to help you turn around, here are four simple things that you could do. It's all about semantics. Instead of saying, I'm so stupid, say, I feel a bit stupid. It may sound silly, but this little change of wording gives you distance and reminds you that your low self-esteem moment is just that, a moment. It may seem like a small nuance, but there's a huge difference. It describes how you feel, not who you are. I always say this, we are our own meanest, harshest critics, and we speak to ourselves in ways that we would never, ever, ever use with any of our friends. So one of the ways to muscle that nasty inner voice is to ask yourself, what would my best friend say? Let's say you forgot to make an important point in your presentation. Will he say, you're a total wuss, you always do that? I don't think so. Or would he say, it's okay, you're allowed to forget, no big deal. Now, in the off chance that your friend says you are a total wuss, suggest to change your friend. I recently messed up so badly in a marketing presentation. I could feel myself stumbling over words, forgetting stuff, and by the time it was time to pitch my course, I was so demotivated that I did a thoroughly bad offer. And instead of people running to the back to sign up for the course, I could hear crickets. Literally crickets. It was one of the most embarrassing moments. Standing in silence, looking like a fool, hoping people will sign up, or at the very least, leave the room quickly. Brené Brown, author of The Gifts of Imperfection, says, shame only works if we keep it secret. So I did what she advised. I picked up the phone, called a friend and said, okay, I'm in a total shame downward spiral. Here's what happened. When you find the courage to do the counterintuitive thing and tell someone what happened, those conversations invariably end up in laughter. And that moment, you basically cut shame off at the knees. Perfectionism is so destructive. The most successful CEOs, athletes, authors, coaches, they credit their success to a willingness to mess up and move on. So, accept your messes, clean up after them and move on. It is so freeing. Embracing your imperfections doesn't mean that you're lowering your standards. You're merely giving yourself the permission to make mistakes and learn from them. Now I know that to use the above steps, you have to be conscious of your negative thoughts and emotions. Those negative voices often seem to slip in through our subconscious. So, here's a tool that I have that you can use immediately and effectively. I like to call this the power of possibility thinking. Hats off to psychologist Tamar Ichansky, author of Freeing Yourself from Anxiety, for this beautiful term. As step one, you have to be more mindful of how you talk to yourself. And as soon as you hear it, don't resist the voice. Just let it be. It's more effective to allow it to exist than to try everything in your power to get rid of it. Watch, hear, or observe these negative self-talk with awareness, but don't get emotionally involved. Think of it like when you're on a phone with a grumpy, whiny relative who just won't stop talking. And you point the phone away from your ear to let the voice yap into nothingness while you stop listening to what it's saying. Now, the most important step is to take charge. Here's what you do. Place the palm of your left hand over your solar plexus area, your right hand if you're a lefty. Then tell the voice, "Thank you for bringing that to my attention." Now focus on filling it in with something constructive. For instance, let's say your voice says, "You're a fat cow, you have no willpower." Say, "Thank you for bringing that to my attention. Now let's focus on how to make this house cake-free." And then act on that something constructive. Do this every time negative self-talk and emotion seems to come up. That's it. So you're not deliberately shoving positive talk down your throat. You're looking at possibilities to change. This simple process helps you take back control of your own mind and take charge of your own life. Just try it out for a couple of weeks, even days, whenever negative self-talk or emotions come up. You'll soon notice the control it gives you over your own mental and emotional state. And once you experience the power and drastic change it can bring, I bet you'll use it for the rest of your life. Put it to work and see what it does for you. And yes, do write in to tell me. Now, don't keep this tool to yourself. Be generous. Share it with your friends and colleagues and family members. Everyone is grappling with negative self-talk loop. Like and share this video. Let's spread the light, folks.